Shriman Venkatanatharya Kavitar Kikesari Vedantacharya Vadyome Sannidhartam Sadahridi Guru Bhyastad Guru Bhyaschanamo Vakamadhi Mahe Vrini Mahe Chatatradyo Dampati Jagatampati Asmad Guru Param Paraye Namaha. Namaskarams. Today we are going to listen to the meaning of the third verse of Sri Nyasa Dashaka. The verse Arpadya is as follows. Swami Swashesham Swavasham Swabharatvena Nirbharam Swadatta Swadhiya Swartham Swasmanyasyati Mam Swajam. Swami Swashesham Swavasham Swabharatvena Nirbharam Svadatta Svadhiya Swartham Swasmin Nyasyati Mam Swayam. Thus goes the third verse of Sri Nyasa Dashaka. Nyasa means Bharanyasa. Our prapatti, which is considered to be a means, upaya, to attain moksha, which is leaving this material world and crossing over to the divine world, which is untouched by the gunas of prakriti, called as aprakrita loka, and to render kaikarya to Bhagavan, which means, which includes both Narayana and Shri or Lakshmi and his devotees, who are either nityas, nityasuris means who have never been into samsara. By the sankalpa of Bhagavan, they have never attained a birth in this world like us due to karma. So they have been there with him since time immemorial, rendering service and immersing themselves in Brahma Anubhava. And the next class is called as Muktas, who have been in the samsara, undergone the suffering, but with the grace of the Paramatma, they have adopted either Bhakti Yoga or Prapatti Yoga, which are considered to be the two means. These two are considered to be the two upayas according to the Sampradaya, because of which they have earned the preeti or pleasure of Paramatma, and as a consequence of him getting pleased, he has granted moksha. Okay, now in the first two verse, the concept of prapatti, how it should be done, what should be the mental mode or bhavana of a prapanna, one who performs prapatti, was explained. In the second verse, the five angas are ancillaries to the angi or the principle, that is the process of prapatti. Those were explained in the second verse. Now this third verse is actually very interesting verse. The meaning would be like this. First, let me share the meaning and then let us take a note of the interesting aspects. The person who does prapatti through an acharya, at the divine feet of the Divya Dampati, has to have this bhavana, this impression in his mind. The Bhagavan himself places or performs this prapatti, makes me to perform this prapatti. Who am I? I am a subordinate and I belong to him. I am dependent on him. He deems this responsibility to be his own. And then the mind with which I do this prapatti has also been given by him. And finally, it is for himself that he places me at his own feet. Now, this is the very high-level meaning of this verse. It could perhaps not be clear when we hear for the first time, and also not paying attention to the interesting points which I mentioned, interesting aspect of this verse. Now the question is there a free will or not? Are we destined to be like this, what we are? Is everything fixed by the Paramatma? Or do the Jivatmas have something called as free will? Now the answer is yes and no. The Jivatmas do have a free will, but that has been given, granted by the Paramatma. He sets up the framework and then we are allowed to play within the framework. We cannot breach that framework. We cannot beat the system. But whatever the intelligence, the jnana that has been bestowed upon us by him, by the Paramatma. So the Jivatma's very existence, it depends on the will of the Paramatma, Sankalpa of the Paramatma. Creation means the coming together of Jivatma and Prakriti, that is in the form of a Sharira or a body. For the first time, after a cycle of the creation and destruction happens. So assuming a pralaya or destruction has happened and it's time for creation. What happens is, it's like taking stock of the merits and demerits of the Jivatmas, and in accordance with the corresponding merits and demerits, new bodies are assigned. So say, let us say somebody would be born as a human being, somebody as an ant, somebody as a bird, etc. Now with whatever the past impressions that they have had, they would continue to lead that life. Now as they proceed, so this is creation coming together with the Prakriti and taking up a body. Now sustenance. Now the thing has to continue, right? The body has been given. So the all the bhutas, the beings have to be given the situation or the conditions to do something, to act. That is sustenance, sthiti, and then finally laya. A time comes when the creation has to be dissolved. Why? Because it cannot go on like this. There is total chaos because of the misdeeds or the apakara of the jivatmas as a class. Now it's time for the creation to end. So where will all the things go? What happens is, it's not complete destruction like how science says. Science also agrees, saying that there can never be complete annihilation. Matter, it changes from one form to another. In the same way, all the gross beings that we see, including the nature as well as the living beings, all these will get reduced to their subtlest form, the most subtle form, sukshma we say. And they will all, what happens is, they will all get struck in the Paramatma, in some form, in an avyakta, in an unmanifested form. Until when? Until the next srishti, next creation. Now, unless we accept that there is some kind of free will given to the Jivatmas, the karma which is performed by them won't make any real sense. If everything is destined, a Jivatma should only act like this, then whatever karma he accumulates would not actually accrue to him. So, it is understood that the Paramatma, what he does is, he kind of gives a free will, a limited independence to the Jivatma, so that they can follow the rules of Shastra, they can understand the Prakriti, they can gain knowledge by approaching a guru, and then eventually they can come back or they can go to Sri Vaikuntha or attain moksha, in other words. Now comes a question, another question. Who does prapatti now? If the prapanna is going to think that I, of my own accord, of my own will and ability, have attained this knowledge and I am going to place myself upon the feet of Bhagavan. So this sense of I-ness and my-ness, I'm going to put myself. So this I-ness and myself, the ahankara mamakara, will not allow the prapatti to get done completely. So they are like doshas, kleshas, which we have to get rid of. So what should be the realization? It's actually the Paramatma who is responsible for our very existence. So he has given this opportunity for us to attain knowledge through an Acharya, and very magnanimously he has forgotten all our past misdeeds, the wrong deeds, and now he has taken the sankalpa to listen to Pirati, that is Shri, and also to the Acharya, and accept our case when they put forward for moksha. So it is Bhagavan who is behind all the activities and actions. So he is behind everything. Whatever we do, we also take part. It is not that only we do. So he makes us do. Like how he says in the Gita, he tells Arjuna that everything is, the background work is done by me. You just shoot the arrow, that's it. You will get the fame. You will get the name that you have killed the Kauravas. But it is all preset by me. Yet, for the sake of the world to function, what I do is that I allow the Jivatmas to exercise their free will and act. So therefore, the Jivatmas are completely dependent upon the Paramatma for their existence, for their pravritti, for their activities. Yet, the Paramatma, what it does is, he kind of gives a limited independence, limited free will, so to say, to act. Because of which, mostly the Jivatmas, they end up performing only those bad deeds. And that's why samsara. Otherwise, samsara, the reason for samsara won't be convincing, so to say. So now, the realization has to happen in the mind of the prapanna, a person who does prapatti. So he has to have this bhavana in himself, that Swami. Swami means my boss, my natha. What he does? Svashesham. Svashesham means that it refers to me, the person who does prapatti, that he has made me, one who is his sheshabhuta, svavasham, and now I am completely under his sway. I am completely now dependent on him. I am completely under his influence. In the sense, I have stopped functioning on my own. So now I am completely dependent upon him. Now this acting on our own becomes a primary reason for us earning the wrath of Paramatma. So the moment we stop acting on our own and falling in line with the Paramatma, what happens is, then it becomes a reason for him to get pleased. I read this story which came through, I think, WhatsApp or don't remember, resource. Very nice story. That is a boat which is crossing a river. So a boatman is there, a sadhu is there, and some people are there. There, in the course of the crossing, what happens is the boatman finds that there is a hole in the boat and water is entering through it, so which could eventually topple the boat. So he gives a word of caution to everyone, saying, please take care of yourselves, be ready if there is an eventuality. We all may have to swim and reach the shore. Then the sadhu, to everyone's amazement, what he does is, he with his kamandala that he has in his hand, the vessel, he draws water from the river and then pours it inside the boat, which means he is adding to the water inside the boat. Now this boatman was watching this, but then suddenly what has happened is, the situation changed, and then somehow the hole got reduced, or maybe it got blocked due to some inhuman, beyond the capacity of a human being. Now, the boatman, now he cries, he shouts happily, saying, no longer you need to worry. Now we have crossed the problem, and the water is no longer entering the boat. Now the sadhu, what he does is, he puts all the water from the boat, he picks it up from his vessel and then throws it into the river. Now the boatman is amazed. Then he asks him, why are you doing so? In fact, you are doing the reverse. When I said there is a lot of water in the boat, you must have emptied the boat, but you chose to draw water from the river and then put it in the boat, and vice versa. To which the sadhu replied, see, we have to fall in line with the Paramatma's will. The moment you said there is a hole in the boat and water is entering very fast, that means the Paramatma has willed, has made a sankalpa to drown all of us. So I take part in that event. So I help him, kind of. Now when you say the water has, water is no longer entering, somehow the hole is blocked or whatever. Now I understood the Paramatma has willed otherwise. So I am trying to help him by putting the water outside. Now the story at a very superficial level may seem to be very funny, or it may give another sense also. But when we look at, when we contemplate about the story, the idea is to fall in line with the will of the Paramatma. That's the theme or idea behind the story. To not exercise our own will, to not interfere in the process after we surrender, basically. After we surrender, we need to be like the proverbial the kitten, which does not even open its eyes and search for the cat. It just remains in the place where it is and then mews, small mew. Now that will be heard by the cat wherever the cat is, and then it will come to help the kittens. So as prapannas, we should have this kind of conviction and then stay put in whatever we do, which is the kaikarya to the Bhagavan, and stop interfering in the will of, or rather in the sankalpa of Bhagavan. So swavasham, so tanak, the Tamil meaning goes as tanak vasapattavanana, to be completely in line with Paramatma. Mam means myself. Svadatta means what has been given by him. What is that? Svadhiya, the jnana about him, the knowledge about him. Because what we need to know very well about what we want to attain. Now in this case, we need to attain the Paramatma. So we need to know pretty clearly about who is the Paramatma and who are we vis-a-vis as a relation to the Paramatma. Swartham. Now as we said in the first shloka, madrakshana palam tata. So the prayojana, the reason for the protection is his own, not ours. Nirbharam svabharatvena. So what he does is he takes off the load from him, considering as if it is his own load, his own responsibility to protect me. And then swayam, he does it himself. He does all these things by himself. Swasmin, which means in himself, he places me, or rather he had made me to place in his divine feet by himself, by giving the right knowledge about himself. So the Sri Vaishnavas are also seen doing something called as Sattvika Tyaga while they perform their Nitya Karma. Even before Sandhya Vandana, they say Bhagavan Evasva Niyamya Surupastiti. That's how it goes. So here also it's kind of a Sattvika Tyaga that we have to do Anusandhanam. There are three things which actually we need to know about the Sattvika Tyaga, three Amshas. One is the Kartritva Tyaga. Kartritva Tyaga means giving up the sense of agency, giving up the notion of agency, that I am doing this. No, Bhagavan is making me do this. So by that, in that way, we give up the notion of Kartritva or agency. And the next one is Mamata Tyaga. This is my activity that I am doing. This is my activity for my sake. No, Bhagavan is making me do this for his own sake. And the third one is Phala Tyaga. The result of this action, it belongs to me. I want to enjoy the fruit. No, we have to give up that thought also, that notion also. This actually the fruit of my protection, it goes to Bhagavan only. It is for his own sake, to enjoy the fruits thereof, he is liberating me. That should be the bhava, mano bhava of the prapanna. So that is being beautifully brought out in the shloka. Swami swashesham swavasham swabharatvena nirbharam swatatta swadhiya swartam swasmin nyasyati mam swayam. In fact, nyasa dashaka is being chanted by Sri Vaishnavas when they do what is known as Thiruvaradhana. Daily prayers offered to Murti of Bhagavan. The Murti could be in the form of a shalagrama or even idols made of metals or wood, etc. So that's the greatness of this short yet very, very important poem, verse called as Nyasa Dashaka. So we have seen the meaning of the third verse. As said before by Adiyen, there is so much to say. But for want of time and want of the right jnana, I stop here. Srimathe Nigamanta Mahadesikaya Namaha.